Yes, dear everyone. Yes, class, maintain silence, last benches there at the corner. I said maintain silence. Are you able to hear my noise? Then listen. Okay, so in the yesterday's class, we had learned about the Abbaus principle, right? So let's revise something about the Abbaus principle. So what is Abbaus principle? Can anyone tell me what is Abbaus principle? See, Abbaus principle, last benches, I'm telling you once again, be quiet. I'll not repeat, I'll simply send you people out. I can clearly see from here who all are talking and who all are simply looking here and there. When I am standing here, that means I can easily identify. Right? So be quiet. So in the yesterday's class, we had learned about the Abbaus principle. What does this Abbaus principle tells us? It tells us about the filling of the electron. Filling of the orbital, sorry. Right? So in the principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number, we had learned about the shells, then subshells, then we had learned about the degenerative orbitals and we had learned about the spins, right? Spins of an electron. Spins of an electron means there are two kinds of a spin, upward spin and the downward spin. That means the principal quantum number tells you about the shells in which the electron is present. Then the azimuthal quantum number tells you about the subshell and magnetic quantum number tells you about degenerative orbitals and spin quantum number tells you about the spin of the electron, whether it is upward direction or whether it is downward direction. Okay, then comes the Abbaus principle. What does the Abbaus principle tells you? It tells you about the filling of the orbital. यानी कि प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर सिर्फ दिखाता है शेल कौन सा है, सब शेल कौन सा है, डीजनरेटिव ऑर्बिटल्स क्या है, स्पिन क्या है और कितने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है, राइट? बट अबाउट प्रिंसिपल टेल्स यू अबाउट द फिलिंग ऑफ द ऑर्बिटल. दैट मींस द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर फिल्ड इन अ व्हाट वे, राइट? सो इट टेल्स यू अबाउट द एनर्जी ऑर्डर ऑफ द शेल्स, राइट? So yesterday we had seen the energy order. Let's look at that energy order. First one is 1s, then 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d. Yes. Out. Stand outside. It is almost 15 minutes. Stand outside. Yes, 4D, 4M, then 5S, 5B, 5D, 5F and 5G, 6S, 6P, 6D, 6F, 6G, 7S, 7B, 7D, 7F and 7G, right? So this is called as the energy order, right? So we had seen that the electron will first go into a 1s, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, right? Like this, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. So this is nothing but called as the increasing energy order. And this is a very, very important question as far as your exam is concerned, right? So everyone should know that how the electrons are filled in the orbitals. Okay, so here, see, what is the meaning of this one? This one represents the n. N means principal quantum number, right? So n is nothing but the principal quantum number. And what is this s? S is nothing but the orbital, right? So this is how the electrons are filled in the orbitals. So this becomes the 1s orbital. This becomes the 2s orbital. Now 2 means what? 2 means second shell. 3 means what? 3 means third shell. 4? 4th shell. 5? 5th shell. 6? 6th shell. 7? 7th shell. Right? So I hope that it is very much clear to all of you that how these shells are there, and along with the shells, we also have the orbitals. Samajh mein aa gaya sabko? Okay, then in this Abbaugh's principle, there are 3 concepts that are very, very important. That is increasing order of energy, right? So ye pehla point humne dekha. Dusra point kya tha? Pauli's exclusion principle. And the third point was Hund's rule of multiplicity. Right? So this was the third point which is to be discussed. Yesterday we had seen the 2 points. First one was increasing order of energy. Now we know how to fill the electrons. Right? इसका यूज क्या है हम लोग, इसका यूज कहां पे करने वाले, इसका यूज हम लोग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन टू राइट द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दिस पर्टिकुलर एनर्जी ऑर्डर. रिमेंबर दिस, राइट? इसके सिवाय हमको इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन लिख नहीं सकते इस ऑर्डर के सिवाय. एंड इन योर बोर्ड एग्जाम you are getting almost 3 mark question for writing the electronic configuration. Right? They will give you the electronic configuration like chromium, zinc, copper, cadmium. Right? Jinka sabka element hai 21 and above. Jitne bhi atomic number 21 and above aate hai. Matlab scandium se leke. See, scandium to zinc. स्कैंडियम टू जिंक मतलब ये सारे के सारे कहां आते हैं? डी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट में आते हैं. तो स्कैंडियम स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 21 एंड जिंक एंड्स टू अ 30. स्कैंडियम का एटॉमिक नंबर क्या है? 21 है. जिंक का एटॉमिक नंबर क्या है? 30 है. सो दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गिव यू अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन. ऐसा नहीं है कि ऐसा बोलेंगे कि सोडियम ले लो और सोडियम का इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन लिखो. नॉट लाइक दिस. Right, that is very, very easy, but they will give you a difficult one which falls into a D block element ranging from scandium 21 to a zinc 30. Right? So hum log kya karne wale? We are going to see today all the elements, right from the first element till the 30 element, we are going to see their electronic configuration. Okay? As well as we will see their scientific notations as well. Okay? So here in this case, first concept is over, then comes the second concept, that is the Pauli's exclusion principle. अभी Pauli's exclusion principle में क्या बोला है कि no two electrons, right? No two electrons will have the same quantum numbers. यानी भी दोनों भी electrons का quantum number same नहीं होगा, right? For example, हमने कल एक example देखा था. What were the values? Can you tell me the values? Can anyone tell me the values quickly? Chalo bolo, n ka value kya tha? What was the value of n? 1. Good. Value of l? It was 1 or 0?
0.
Value of ml?
0.
Value of ms?
Plus half.
So this was for the first electron. This is for the first electron. Now, for the second electron, n is equals to l is equals to ml is equals to ms is equals to minus half. So, did you understand the difference? Did you understand the difference? That means the Pauli's exclusion principle tells you that the quantum numbers will not be same. Right? चार क्वांटम नंबर से में से एक क्वांटम नंबर डिफर होगा, दैट विल बी दी स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर. व्हाई? बिकॉज वन विल हैव अ अपवर्ड स्पिन एंड वन विल हैव अ डाउनवर्ड स्पिन. दैट इज व्हाई द वैल्यू इज गोइंग टू चेंज. सो इज डिड यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड पॉलीज एक्सक्लूजन प्रिंसिपल? ओके, नाउ लेट्स गो फॉर दी हंड्स रूल ऑफ मल्टीप्लिसिटी. गिव द हेडिंग. Yes, last bench, you get up from there. Quickly get up from there. Yes, get up. commensurate here. There is unnecessary talking going on at the back. Yes, write down. Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Write down the statement. Pairing of electron in the orbitals belonging to the same subshell does not occur unless each orbital belonging to that subshell has got one electron each. Right? So this is called as the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Right? So what is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity? Pairing of electron in the orbital belonging to the same subshell does not occur unless each orbital belonging to that subshell has got one electron each. Right? So from this statement you might be finding it little bit confusing, but I will make you explain in a very easy way. Right? Let's say that this is our orbital. Right? This is 2px, this is p orbital. 2px, 2py and 2pz. So what is the maximum capability of the p orbital? 6 electrons, right? Now let's say that if I have 4 electrons in this, right? So how I am going to fill this? Am I going to fill like this? 1, 2, 3, 4? No. This is the wrong way of filling the electrons. So what does this particular rule says? This rule of Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity says that each orbital will get one electron first and then the pairing will start. So the filling of the electron, let's say that we have 4 electrons. This is px, this is py, this is pz. So first the electron will go into px, then second electron will go into py, then into pz. And the fourth electron which is remaining will get paired with this px. Are you understanding? This is the correct way of filling the orbitals. Right? So, yahan pe kya batata hai ki filling of the orbitals kaise hota hai? Agar ye dekhoge pehla wala case, so this is absolutely wrong. Because you can clearly see that the pz orbital is empty. Right? Which is not possible. But the second case you can see that each of the orbital is getting one electron and the energy of the system is getting balanced and then comes the fourth electron into px and it is getting samajh mein aa gaya kya? To isme zyada kuch rocket science nahi hai. It is very simple. Inhone itna hi bola hai ki sabse pehle kya hoga, har ek orbital mein ek ek electron jayega aur jitne bachenge fir baad mein pairing mein chale jayega. Did you understand this? Okay, then write down example p subshell, right? So you can copy down this as an example, right? And write down this is the correct way and this is the wrong way. Right? Correct way of representation and wrong way of representation. so that it will become easy for you all to study in the exam. Yes, write down electronic configuration of first 30 elements. Electronic configuration of first 30 elements. Yes, make the table, write down atomic number element and electronic configuration. Yes, stop talking. Yes, everyone make this table, atomic number, element and electronic configuration. And one thing everyone should remember, I am going to take a conductor one test on this electronic configuration. 10 mark test. I should see that everyone is able to write the electronic configuration. It is a very, very important question as far as your board exam is concerned. Isko likh lo. VIMP, very important. Close. Okay, write down first element, hydrogen. Atomic number, 1. Electronic configuration,
1s2.
1s2? 1s1. Yes. Next. Element number 2. Helium. Atomic number? 1s2. Atomic number I said. 2. Configuration? 1s2. Right? Configuration 1s2. Yes. Second last bench you get up. Yes. You get up from there. I said him. You get up, what is going on? Can't you understand or what? What nonsense you are doing? Better go out. Can't you understand? Come on, come from there. Come and sit here. Quickly. That side. Sit that side. Yes, second element is the helium and the configuration is 1s2, right? So how many electrons s can occupy? 2 electrons. Okay, third element, lithium. Lithium, what is the atomic number of lithium? 3. Atomic number, not electronic configuration. Try to understand the difference. Difference samjhun gaya kya hai. So what will be the configuration? 1s2. 2s1. Very good. 1s2, 2s1. Next. Atomic number 4. Beryllium. Come on. 1s2. 1s2, 2s2. Next. Atomic number 5. Tell me the element. Boron. 1s2. 2s2. 2p. 1, 2p1, next, atomic number 6, carbon, good, atomic number 6, carbon, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, देखो कितने नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है, देखो यहाँ पे 6, 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, right? So there are total 6 electrons present in the carbon. Okay? You all understand this? Okay, next, atomic number 7, bolo chalo element, nitrogen. Write down the configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Very good, 2p3. Next,
oxygen.
Close that window also. Are you able to see now? Still not? Come in the front. Be in the front. बंद कर रहे हैं बंद कर पता जिसके यार वहां से प्रिंसिपल ना हो. ओके, नेक्स्ट
ऑक्सीजन
एटॉमिक नंबर 8
ऑक्सीजन.
यस, राइट डाउन द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन.
सर की लाइट बंद कर
बंद केलं तर सगळंच. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, 2p4. Yes, did you all write down all the configurations from 1 to 8? Okay. Now next. Maintain silence. Second last benches. Maintain silence. What is going on? Yes, you both of you stand up from there. Stand up. Yes, come out. Go and stand at there at the last. Go. Yes. Right up. Next, atomic number 9. Atomic number 9. Tell me the element. Chlorine. Electronic configuration, come on, you should be able to write now.